Hey guys, Johnny here, back with more COD Mobile, and today we talk about the Heavy Shot event and why I think it's not as bad as people say on the Reddit. I will share with you guys some tips to go straight for the gun in the least amount of time or games as possible. And watch the whole video, guys, because I love the weapon so much that I will gamble a little bit and spin a few times and see if I can get lucky with the Color Spectrum KN44. So let's get into it, guys. Before we start, smash the like and of course subscribe to the channel if you are new for more Call of Duty Mobile videos. So, now the Heavy Shot event is all about the weapon and it's what the community have been asking since the very first lucky draw. The only thing people want is, please, when you release a new weapon for money, can you at least release at the same time a free version, like a common version, an unskinned version for the free-to-play players, so they don't have to wait 3 months before they get the new weapon. So it's exactly what they did, guys. They released a new weapon, the KN44, at the same time they released the Heavy Shot event, and you have to complete tasks to unlock the free KN44. And by the way, guys, it is amazing. I love it. I unlocked it earlier today on stream. First time I use it, I fell in love. I love this weapon so much. Like I said, I will gamble a little bit in this video. I will spin the wheel, spend some COD points, see if I can get lucky with the Spectrum skin. Now, the huge controversy right now is people are complaining that it's too long, there's too much to do, you have to play too many games, it's gonna take forever to get the soldier, okay? That's the problem. You don't need the soldier skin. It's just another skin. You probably have already a bunch of cool ones. Are you even gonna use it? Do you need another soldier skin? Because it's about the weapon, guys. We do this for the weapon. So you can skip the soldier and just go for the weapon and you won't have to play that much. So look, I got the weapon today. I didn't do 30 games of frontline. I did not do 30 games of TDM. I did not do 30 games of domination, okay? But I just did the other challenges. So my experience is it was not even that bad. I played maybe 2 hours today and maybe an hour yesterday. I can't even remember because I played Battle Royale for other challenges. I didn't play that much, okay? But first thing you need to do, guys, team up with a friend because you have to play 15 games with friends. That's the bottom one here. 5 games with friends and 15 games with friends. So that is 2 challenges already just for playing with a friend. And then I would say jump into team deathmatch and equip Sparrow on your loadout and just play a bunch of team deathmatch until you get your 15 Sparrow kills. So maybe you won't get it in 10 games. If it takes 11, 12, 13 games, I mean, so be it. But just play TDM until you get your 15 kills with the Sparrow. Usually you will use your Sparrow once every game, usually. And sometimes you're gonna get a kill, sometimes not, and sometimes you're gonna get 2 or 3 kills. But that would be step one. Team up with a friend, TDM, Sparrow, get rid of your 10 kills. And at the same time, you're gonna get some MVPs, I hope. But it's pretty random. It's not something you can calculate. But you need to get some MVP. You need to get some first places to get one of these challenges. Place MVP 5 times in total to get that challenge done. So that's the step one. That's what I did yesterday on stream. I teamed up with my buddy. We played a bunch of TDM and I got my MVPs here and there. And then once you're done, if you get your 15 kills before you got 10 games in TDM, I would say finish your 10 games because you need to play 10 for that achievement. And then you will move to frontline. You need to get 10 kills with the Hunter Killer drone in frontline. And you need to play 10 games of frontline. So guys, just a quick tip, if you wanna have a better chance to get your 10 kills with the killer drone, this is what I did. I did change my last perk on all my loadouts that I was using, and I did go with hardline. Just for the time that I needed to get my killer drone kills, I switched to hardline on my loadouts, so you get to your killer drone faster, and you're gonna have more opportunities to use it. Yeah, you still need a little bit of a kill streak, but it's gonna be faster. And what I did, every time I got the killer drone, remember it's in frontline, your enemies have invincibility when they respawn. So if you go and throw your killer drone in their spawn, probably is gonna hit someone that's invincible, you're gonna fail and miss an opportunity. So what I do is I stay in the back and wait for my enemies to come to the middle, and then I shoot my killer drone on them. So I have a better chance at least to get a kill and not waste my killer drone. Second tip, as soon as I got my drone, I would go and die. You can kill yourself with a nade or just rush the spawn and they will kill you, don't worry. But I would die right after my killer drone to restart my kill streak and get another killer drone. So sometimes I would get two or three killer drones in the same game. Of course, you won't always get a kill, but you're gonna get some kills here and there. And because of that, I did get my 10 kills in exactly 10 games of Frontline. I did not have to play more than 10 games. So step one, TDM and Sparrow. When you're done, switch to the killer drone, do some Frontline games, 10 games with 10 kills with a Hunter killer drone. And then you're gonna move to Domination. You have to play 10 games and capture 15 points. Guys, 15 points was done very fast. Every game of Domination, you get a capture at the start and at the start of the half. So you get at least 2 free caps every game. So if you play 10 games, you get 20 caps without even trying. And you can, I don't want to say go AFK, but some guys just go AFK. Almost every game I see a guy AFK in the spawn. So some dudes are grinding the 30 games. They just go in public games, they stay in the spawn, they go eat, they go take a shower. I don't know what they do. Maybe watch some YouTube. But yeah, like, because you don't need to win. You just need to play. But like I said, very easy to just get the weapon. I just did these steps. I got my weapon super fast. But then if you want to go for the skin, the soldier, well, I would say just finish your TDM games and finish your frontline games and you're done. You don't have to play 30 games of Domination. There's extra points, my viewers told me on stream. You don't need to finish all the tasks. And you'll get everything. So it's up to you guys. But I mean, the complaining on Reddit is ridiculous. The amount of threads that I've seen the post about people not happy with the event. Well, what I say is just don't do it then. Like, it's not like you need it. But the weapon, if you just need the weapon, super easy. So I did use the weapon. I love it. And I will spin the lucky wheel, the lucky draw a few times today, guys. Fingers crossed. I don't want to go and spend 200 bucks for a weapon skin. But there's a few other cool stuff. The soldier skin, not my favorite. The backpack is cool. The new robot dance, I would really, really like that one. The Arctic 50 for Battle Royale. I like the Yukio E skin. So there's a few cool items. The two backpacks are nice. The epic one, of course, is animated. I think it's the first animated backpack. Not sure though. But I got 3,000 COD points. I don't know how much I want to spend. Probably something like, I don't know, 2,000 maybe. Depends how fast it goes. But we're going to go with the first spin, guys. And like, let's see if we can get lucky. I know the odds, by the way. I'm not stupid. I played Lucky Draw a few times. I know it's like super, super low odds to get something cool at the start. But we start with the Arctic 50, super cheap, 40 COD points, so gotta be happy with that one. And yeah, there is a possibility that you might get something early, but it's not likely. This one's pretty cool, super cheap. So next one's gonna be 120, so that's a pretty big jump. I thought it was gonna jump to 80. But yeah, for 120 COD points, if you can get, I don't know, parachute is cool. The backpack, the two backpacks are nice, but the robot dance would be nice. Or something super rare. Why not? Let's go. Spin number two. It's the shotgun. The BY-15. By the way, I love these shotguns. I use it a little bit in multiplayer this season. This one's pretty cool. All right. How much for the next spin? 200 COD points. So we can go for another spin for sure. Let's go for 200. Give me something nice, please. Oof. Anytime it goes on one of these two big squares. All right. BK-57. Is a weapon that I never ever use. Like, it's pretty good, but there's better weapons, right? There are better weapons. I don't know if you guys like that one, but it's very accurate and all. It's got decent range, but not a big fan. All right, we jump to 350 now. I can spend 1,005 more at least. I don't want to spend all my cut points. Come on, baby. One of the two backpacks. It's pretty cool. Yukio E backpack. And we're down to two epics. And three epics. and a few blues. So we're gonna start seeing some cool stuff now. 700 for the next spin. Let's go. Oof. And it's the grenade. It's a sticky grenade. I always use the frag grenades. I never use, like, ever the stickies. That one's pretty cool. I don't know if I'll start using them again in the future, but I'm a big fan of frags. All right, what's left for 900? Probably is gonna be the parachute. And then I might stop. But if I do one more spin after, it's gonna be the Spectrum backpack or the emote. So yeah, I'll have to think about it. But let's go for one more, and it's gonna be my last spin. And very likely it's gonna be the parachute. But still, we have to try, right? Fingers crossed. Oh, let's go. Between the dance and the parachute, I'll take the dance anytime. So I guess I'm okay to stop now. Because I was thinking, if I get the parachute, I would kind of have to do one more spin, because I would get the dance guaranteed, or the animated backpack. But next spin is going to be 1200. I would have to buy more card points. But I think I'm going to stop right here. Like I said, I really like the weapon. I don't think it's worth 200 bucks. It's a lot of money for a weapon skin. And the basic one, by the way, I like the looks of it. Like black with the brown mag. So yeah, guys, that's going to be it for now. Leave a comment below what you think about the whole event situation. Do you think it's too much of a grind? Do you think it's worth to go for the soldier skin or not? Honestly, I'll go for it just because I want to, but I'm probably not going to use it. I have a lot of soldiers that I really like over the Prophet skin. So yeah, I think it's not a big deal, but whatever. Thank you guys so much for watching. Hope you enjoyed the video. Once again, hit the like if you did. Subscribe to the channel for more Call of Duty Mobile videos. I will see you guys in the next one. Take care.